we're asked to multiply the radicals. Notice here we have the product of cube roots. For number 1, we have the cube root of 4 times the cube root of 12. Because the radicals have the same index, meaning they're both cube roots, to find their product, we multiply the radicands. This is equal to the cube root of 4 times 12. Because we need to simplify, we will not find this product. We'll determine the prime factors of 4 and 12. 4 equals 2 times 2. 12 equals 2 times 6. 6 equals 2 times 3. The prime factorization of this product is 4 factors of 2 and a factor of 3. Because we have a cube root, we're looking for perfect cube factors, which means we circle groups of 3 equal factors. So 2 times 2 times 2 is a perfect cube, and therefore this will simplify. The cube root of 2 times 2 times 2 simplifies to 1 factor of 2, and therefore this simplifies to 2 times the cube root of 2 times 3, which is 6. For number 2, we have 7 cube root 54 times 2 cube root 28. Again, because the indexes are the same, or they're both cube roots, to find the product, we multiply the numbers on the outside together, and then multiply the radicands together. So the product is 7 times 2 times the cube root of 54 times 28. So the next step, we'll determine the prime factorization of 54 and 28. 54 is equal to 6 times 9. 6 equals 2 times 3. 9 equals 3 times 3. 28 equals 7 times 4. 4 equals 2 times 2. So for the next step, 7 times 2 is 14. So we have 14 times the cube root of. For the prime factorization, we have 1, 2, 3 factors of 2. 1, 2, 3 factors of 3. And a factor of 7. Now we identify the perfect cube factors of the radicand. 2 times 2 times 2 is a perfect cube, and so is 3 times 3 times 3. So simplifying, we have 14 times the cube root of 2 times 2 times 2 is 1 factor of 2, times the cube root of 3 times 3 times 3 is 1 factor of 3, and we still have times cube root 7. 14 times 2 times 3 equals 84. This simplifies to 84 cube root 7. Now for the last example, we have the cube root of 9x squared times the cube root of 30x to the fifth. The indexes are the same, so we multiply by multiplying the radicands. So the product is equal to the cube root of 9 times 30, and then x to the second times x to the fifth is x to the seventh. Now we'll determine the prime factors of 9 and 30. 9 is equal to 3 times 3. 30 is equal to 3 times 10. 10 is equal to 2 times 5. So we have a factor of 2. 3 factors of 3, a factor of 5, and now for x to the 7th, x to the 6th is a perfect cube factor. To show this, let's write x to the 7th as x squared times x squared times x squared, which is x to the 6th, so I have one more factor of x. And now we circle the perfect cube factors. 3 times 3 times 3 is a perfect cube, and so is x squared times x squared times x squared. So simplifying, the cube root of 3 times 3 times 3 is 1 factor of 3. The cube root of x squared times x squared times x squared is 1 factor of x squared. And we're left with the cube root of 2 times 5 times x, which is 10x. I hope you found this helpful.